What? You didn't know that Kusaka and I were pals? I don't get you, Shinsengumi dog. Got more to say? I must admit, I admire your pluck. Fine by me. Shoot! We met way back when I was traveling around the country looking to improve my skills. How many years ago was that again? sorry, I forget. Anyway, when I left Tosa and was looking for somewhere to stay, he was the first person who came to mind. And during my time in Choshu, we spent every day discussing various social problems and honing our skills. A fine man, that Kusaka. You know me well! Huh? All right, then. See you around.
Been looking after yourself?
Do I look like I have the time for chit-chat? Hurry it up.
Me? Well, get to the point, then. There's a trove of knowledge to be found in the West. The first time I saw for myself what Zed accomplished, I realized how little I really knew. Aside from cholera, there are a lot of illnesses our medicine can't cure. If we don't learn what we can from the West, our country is all but doomed. It's simple. If we want to save lives, we shouldn't be dwelling on what divides our countries. Not that I'm endorsing the Red Demon's methods. Throwing me in jail for the most tenuous of connections to the expulsionists. It makes my blood boil. You've done well. Suits me. Try to stay out of trouble, you hear?
Ah, you're here. What can I do for you? Go ahead. All right. If you'll excuse me.
Thought you might show. You need equipment? I am your man. What do you need? Don't lose heart, you hear?
I've got all sorts of medicine.
You have to look after yourself.
need something? Oh, all right, I suppose. Only ever in the company of comrades like Kosaka and Ito. After all, I care little for flashy entertainers. I didn't come all the way to Edo to gallivant in the pleasure district. It'd be a shame if my aspirations were thwarted by sheer debauchery. Through abstinence and the weathering of trials, one discovers unexpected paths forward. At least that's my theory. Master Shoen taught me a great deal. I used to believe that philosophy would only interfere with one's combat training. Hence, the lateness of my joining his school. But once I began my studies, I realized how utterly ignorant I'd been. Unfortunately, Master Shoen moved to Yokohama a month after my arrival. What I did learn in that short time I studied under him will likely stay with me for the rest of my life. This is great! Oh, I see.
We meet again!
By your leave.
Can I help you? All right, though I may not be the right person to ask. Do I? Oh, why, it is an earthly paradise. The Miyazaki and Yoshiwara are home to the most beautiful women in the land. Indeed, I will never forget my first visit to such a world of sensory delight. Takasaki served as my guide. Boy, did I cut loose that night. But when at last it came time to pay the bill, I came up short. So, I had somebody run and fetch Katsura. Let me tell you, never have I seen that mild-mannered man so angry. When I heard the Red Demon was continuing his oppression, I couldn't idly watch from the safety of my domain. But I never once imagined that Master Shoen would be arrested. I nearly fell over when I heard the news. If only I could have spoken to him before he died. My failure to do so will surely haunt me for as long as I live. The very least I can do is help others to carry out his last will and testament. Top notch! Ah, understood. Be seeing you then.
You look well. What's going on with you today? Oh? Go on then. Obviously, we had a hard time putting food on the table, and my little sister nearly ended up in the pressure district. I realized what was happening and went to get her. I yelled, "If you're going to kill us, do it fast!" Which shocked them, gave us a chance to escape. I wish I could say that was the worst that happened. Let's just say I'm glad Father's back, and I have you to thank for that. So thank you. I shouldn't have underestimated you. Huh? All right, then. See you.
Oh, you came! Have you got something to say to me? Then I shall try my best to answer you. Sure I do. They trust me. And why shouldn't they? I'm strong, and I look out for our younger officers. Well, I'm sure the same can be said of Hijikata as well. But everyone is scared of that man. Wonder why? Maybe it's his face? Hijikata is a fine man, but he's not exactly charming. I, on the other hand, am different, as you can tell. You have a good eye for these things. I see. Our conversation is done.
So you came. What did you want to say? Yes? What is it? Kondo invited me to join. Besides, I thought it would give me ample opportunity to see real life or death combat. That's the honest truth. I don't really mind one way or the other what becomes of Japan or the Shogun. Oh, this is nice. Understood.
Admit defeat now.
Casualties to a minimum. Please accept this. It's all I have.
I have a fine selection. What kind of medicine do you seek? Do look after yourself.
Oh, it's you. Do you have some business with me? And what might that be? No, not really. After all, I only belonged to the Tennen Lishin school a short time before Kondo inherited it. But the bond between two people cannot be measured by time alone. Indeed, all of what I am now, I owe to Kondo. Had I not met that man, I'd probably be back in my hometown, wasting my life away, peddling worthless goods. It's my job to instill order among the soldiers. A thankless job, to be sure. But you can't command respect without a bit of fear, can you? I hate to say it, but the Shinsengumi is a ragtag bunch. They need constant discipline, lest they let their enemies, or their allies, get the best of them. Hence our strict code, which culminates in a fitting punishment for those who dishonor the way of the samurai. Ritual suicide. Very nice. All right, then. That is all.
Thanks.
Child's play.
Thank you. Hmm.